Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, sliceonbroadway.com. And listeners like you, support this show at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Just wait, just wait. It is the Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 543. Tuesdays we've been doing this. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitter in the Mayhem Studios here in Pittsburgh, PA, ready to talk some professional wrestling with some hombres of mine with us, of course, from Poughkeepsie, New York. He's back. He's on the show. He is Mad Mike.
I am here, Sorg, and we are not talking about Gotham anymore, because fuck that show.
Oh.
Your hate for Gotham.
Fairly disagreeing on the status of Gotham, yet he's the one that's caught up, and I'm not.
Hashtag not my cobblepot.
Also with us, you can find out more about that discussion over on the Wrestling Mayhem Show Gold on the Patreon, which we'll talk about in just a moment. But I also want to introduce with me as well is Wheels.
I'm back.
Yes, he is. Sound guy for the Renegade Wrestling Alliance and all around general nice guy.
Yes, I love Gotham. No, I don't. I don't even watch Gotham. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about.
So
give me some wonderful Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Give me some Supergirl. Give me some Grimm, and I'm fine. Oh, and of course, give me some wrestling.
Either way, not what this podcast is about, except for that final thing.
Well, I mean, we could talk about Arrow this week.
I guess we can. Cody Rhodes was on there, or whatever his name is these days. I just want to apologize. I know we advertised April Sarah to be come back on the show this week. We had some technical issues with that, so hopefully we can reschedule her for the coming weeks. But we got a lot of great guests lined up, including we did just announce the date, December 20th, will be our Christmas episode, so mark it. That's the night that I get drunk behind the board in the studio, and I still have presents in here that I can't show on camera from last time. The sexy, talented dudes visited us, so look out for that on December 20th for the live stream. For all the shows, there will be the Christmas episodes is the plan.
It's a Tammy Sitch fleshlight.
I will neither confirm nor deny. But in the meantime, you can check us out, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe to the show on Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, or the video versions on the Facebook or the YouTube. And a lot of times there's some live streams on there, like this show, which is every Tuesday night at 10 p.m. Eastern Time, live.WrestlingMayhemShow.com. We are having some issues with the chat room, so we may end up kind of moseying that over to the Facebook situation. Because we seem to be having a little bit more luck actually conversing with you guys on there. So please bear with us while we're dealing with our technical difficulties there. But we do appreciate everybody does try to watch the show, communicate with us, even hitting us up on Twitter. I do get the notifications on this Pebble Watch here during the show. And everybody's been giving us feedback, positive and negative this week. Everybody's getting us feedback on Twitter about the show. I especially appreciate the fellow last night that was, I posted something about Donald Trump using Facebook Live as kind of a tech angle from one of my other things I'm into. And we had a conversation about Monday Night Raw on my personal feed on Facebook. Mike, I think you were part of that as well, because I was a little like in the wrap up as in it went up this morning.
Hashtag not my WWE Hall of Fame.
But anyways, it was.
Sorry.
I just caught up on that. I'm appreciating the feedback that everybody's been giving us this last week, and we do listen to you guys, and we do talk about like a lot of that feedback too. Like that, we do share that in the Slack, so everybody sees what's going on with that, and we're doing what we can do here. So. Also, you guys can drop us a line, as I mentioned, at Mayhem Show on the Facebook page, or 412-206-WMS0, or Good Times.
Good Times!
Good Times!
Good Times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. And you can also support us on the Patreon. Thank you to our good friends, of course, Bo Diggity! Woo! Give us a dollar over there per episode, patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. And of course, the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment. Woo! We should give a woo for everyone, guys.
Well, no. No. All right, Sorg, see, we haven't mentioned this enough.
What?
If you donate to our Patreon, we will address you any way you tell us to.
Right, like the Matthew
and Jennifer. Because you are essentially our bosses at that point.
Like the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment.
Right.
Yeah.
So if you're looking to like advertise, like if you have a podcast or a show or anything, or a blog, we'll advertise that shit.
We get mentioned. And we have, if you want even more than that, we have other levels for that kind of stuff too. Also, Edward Burke, thank you for being a Patreon supporter. Alex Carrs out there in Cali, California. And Bobby Snyder, whoever that is. And brand new Patreon supporter. Thank you so much, Christopher Bishop, for joining us as well. Patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. Hey, shout out.
I assume he came back from the future to tell us all about how podcasts are better in the future.
I hope so.
I assume that with anyone with the last name of Bishop.
I was just thinking of some Days of Future Past 90s X-Men, man. I was just thinking about that like in the shower today.
He's now our X-Man.
Because that's where I consider X-Men storylines and try to figure them out. They're very complicated. Okay. I've been reading a lot of Marvel, and Old Man Logan just came in from the library. So this is not that show. That's Panel Riot. Go panelriot.com. Anyways, so... Oh, hey, shout-outs to Obsessed with... No. Damn it.
No.
Damn
no,
it. I'm so sorry.
Not that one, Sorg. Hashtag not my plug.
Hashtag not my plug, yes. Power to the Smarks, Occupy Pro Wrestling on the podcasters. I'm on the podcast is what I'm trying to get at. Occupy Pro Wrestling, Power to the Smarks on the Twitter. And look up the latest podcast. I'm on there. This is me after about 6 hours on a plane going to California. And I think we had hit up the town for the night. And and I have a conversation with Alex Carrs about, I don't even know. What did we talk? What does he say that we talked about? We talked about wrestling. What started the Wrestling Mayhem Show? Uh-oh. And the origins of my video production work with Sorgatron Media and more. I should probably go listen to this. This was in June. So I'd love to hear what I thought about things. No, go check it out. PowerToTheSmarks.com. It's the OPW podcast, Revenge of the Smarks, on there. And he gives a lot of great stuff, some thoughts about stuff going on in wrestling, some news. He's doing a lot of catch-ups, and so he hasn't had a show on for a bit, but please go check it out. Support other wrestling podcasts. Guys, I understand there's a show this weekend.
Wait.
I think
it's some kind of enclosure.
Some kind of enclosure. Yeah. Keeping you in. It's got a roof. It's a little
it's really hellacious.
I've heard it's quite dangerous, or at least it used to be.
It was once known as a dangerous structure, a demonic structure of hell.
Now it's more like, I don't know.
It's more like a kitten kennel.
It's kind of a heck in the sec.
Hell in a Cell is this weekend, guys. Yeah. That's what we're trying to get at. If that bit went too long. I'm excited for this one, guys. Man, Mike, I know we've had these discussions about how some of these are going to go, but in my mind, Hell in a Cell means Hell in a Cell. And the way some of these are being built up, it's going to be hot damn Hell in a Cell. All these matches, holy crap, they're going to be good.
Guys, all right. See, here's the thing, but I think the matches are going to be perfectly fine.
Mm-hmm.
I have no issues with any of the matches. I think they're going to be great. But I'm just saying, if you did a drinking game with how many times the cell was actually used, pretty sure you'd be able to drive home okay.
We'll test that, and we'll see if I can get up the stairs.
Okay.
Side note. Did you guys, at some point, before like pay-per-views were $10 a month, have a place where you would go and watch these things?
Yes.
This could be, I think I'm inventing a segment here. So I found myself north of the town last weekend and realized the place I used to go is now closed. Yes, the Fox and Hounds up on McKnight Road apparently does not exist anymore. It was the place to go see these, and they had UFC pay-per-views and everything like that, right? Mike, I know we watched... what did we watch? A UFC fight or something?
We watched UFC. UFC at Hooters.
Was that Hooters?
That was Hooters.
What? Really?
Yeah.
Was it a Brock fight?
Yes.
I don't remember.
I believe it was.
In New York or here?
Yeah. In New York. I've never been out there for
that was a Hooters.
Yeah, it definitely was a Hooters.
Now I just thought it was a regular bar. Apparently I didn't notice the ladies.
I did.
I was too
busy. See, and that's the difference. Sorg is married. I'm not.
I was going to say, that just shows Sorg is a very faithful married man.
Happily married man.
Well, I mean, yes. I'm just thinking back to how barbaric a times that was. Right?
We had to scour WWE for the fan zones.
Yes, yes. Like, okay, there's one about a half an hour from my house. You know, and like some bar I've never heard of before, Fox and Hound. I remember, where were we? We were in Philly. When we went to Philly for Chikara, it was Sunday. They had the early show for Chikara, and the Royal Rumble was... No, not the Royal Rumble.
No, it wasn't the Royal Rumble.
Whatever it was. Whatever show it was, you know, we're like, oh, Fox and Hound usually carries these back home. We go to the Fox and Hound in like downtown Philly, and nobody was there.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, we did do that, didn't we?
Yeah, you were there for that.
I was. Oh, wow. I completely forgot about that.
Versus,
we had prime seats for the big screens, though.
Right. We were like right there at the bar and just grabbing a bite. And we're like, this is weird because back home, we had to get there like 3 hours early and pay a cover charge eventually and do all this stuff. And it's just like, I can't believe the stuff we used to go through to watch WWE shows. You know, not including the fact that if we bought them at home, it was $65 at some point. Yeah.
Sorg, it got to a point when I was, and this says a lot about New York City. During pay-per-view nights when I was in college, there was nowhere to watch pay-per-views. I almost went to a strip club once because they were advertising the pay-per-view.
Do you know the setup of what this was? Like, is it like, I'm trying to, okay, in my mind,
I assume business in the front, party in the back. And I've broken Sorg. I have broken Sorg. I have broken Sorg. We are keeping the camera on him. This is great.
I can't find a button. I'm laughing too hard. Okay.
Proceed.
I'm just going to leave that one there. Okay.
No, I assume it was because it was also like a sports bar. But they had like a stripping establishment part of it.
Stripping establishment.
a clothes removal enterprise.
Stop it! You're killing Sorg.
I don't know.
This is what happens when we start the show at 11. We got this bitch up to 11.
Is it
the poles that they danced on? They probably kicked the ball through the uprights.
No.
I'm envisioning that they only stripped to wrestling theme songs, which would be amazing.
Yes! Yes!
I would love that. Like if you just see one chick like that's doing the really slow, seductive one, and it's like, the end is here! I mean, you know, I'm not a strip club DJ, but I could be one because that would be amazing.
Oh, jeez.
Or how about
that would be very seductive.
You want me?
Yeah, see? I mean, you could just play Sunny's theme song on a loop. The Bella Twins could actually be used. Well, actually, I was in college, so the Bella Twins weren't a thing then.
In my mind, like, this is happening, and there's a screen over here, and maybe they have several of them, and the show's on, and a bunch of people came in because of the pay-per-view, and they're more like, leave me alone,
Like
Triple H is coming out.
You see things bouncing up and down. It's like, oh, that's a spot. That's a spot. That's a spot. It's like watching porn. But like looking at the background characters.
I got nothing.
So Hell in a Cell is this weekend, Sork.
I wish our guest was still on.
She probably would have left.
Sure, maybe that's why she left. I don't know. This was going downhill fast. Well, I think it's only
at. That's not good for me. I'm on wheels.
God damn it.
Did you know that he's in a wheelchair? Is anybody out there? I know you can't tell on audio, but now you know. After all these years. Now Mike's broken.
Yep. I just pictured it. I pictured the show going downhill. I pictured wheels not being able to stop. So Hell in a Cell. Yes. Sword, which Hell in a Cell match are you most excited
for? Charlotte.
Sorry, we're getting a little bit of break up there. I think it's in the system here, or it's just the internet just knowing. I would say definitely the women. I mean, I think the biggest sell this week was the women. I talked about it on the wrap up, like that, the fully coming out and saying, "Do you really want to do this? Is this that important?" And then I listened to a commercial where he's putting over the women deserve a chance to do me in Hell in a Cell. And now it's like, Foley's having second thoughts about this, you know? And again, a Foley just from the heart promo like that is always, always helpful. And that the ladies came back at it, right? I would be disappointed at this point. I think I would be disappointed if this is not a match of the year, show stealing, end of the show thing, right?
Yeah.
Like,
but I mean, it has to be brutal.
Yes.
Like I think at this point they've oversold it so much. But there's honestly, no way it can live up to that promo's hype. There's no honestly, way it can.
You're dealing with a Flair and Banks. I think they could do it. I think, honestly, they would put their bodies
on
the line. Like, unlike some of the earlier divas or women's wrestlers.
Well, see, here's the thing. I'm not putting it on Sasha and Charlotte. I know they could tear the house down if they are allowed to.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Like, I mean, at this point, you're almost expecting one of them to, like, come off the side of the cell. Mm-hmm. And they're not going to do that. Like,
I don't think much is rolled out. So
I don't know. It seems like they've oversold it. It seems like they've oversold it. And anything they do now that isn't like ultra violent, like at least there's got to be like some kind of table spot or something has to happen. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's kind of a letdown.
I think if anybody, maybe they need to do, they can do something spectacular that isn't what you're thinking what they can't do, right? I think these two girls that you know, what would you call Bailey and Sasha last year?
But that wasn't a sell.
It wasn't a sell, but it was brutal. It didn't need a sell.
It was brutal because Sasha almost looked like she died.
Right. Well, and she's really good at that. Sasha is like the Dolph Ziggler that actually wins of the women's division.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I hope it's a good match. I'm sure it will be a good match, but I think they oversold it. And I think people are going to be let down with how much they use the sell.
Well, we'll see. From there, of course, you know, we got Rusev and Reigns with their interviews last night.
I fast forwarded through that.
It was a weird, like, there was good stuff, but not much that actually was go home material to me.
Yeah.
That's because
like nothing's happening in that match.
Right. Owens,
like we all know this.
Yeah, that's going to be the sleeper. That's going to be the Hell in a Cell. But really, what's going to happen to this match of the three of them? I could be wrong. It could be the most brutal one. I mean, it's the two guys that probably should be the most brutal of them all, right? But we'll see. Like I said, you're gonna have three very different Hell in a Cell matches in the long run. Owens and Rollins, it's gonna be a classic because it's Owens and Rollins. I don't think we really had a tease last night of maybe Jericho being kind of goofy with this, but
Triple H.
It's gotta be a Triple H time.
Triple H doing the Edge gimmick, posing as a cameraman.
The largest cameraman ever.
Yeah.
Well, you won't see him until the end.
Right. Right, exactly.
But if Triple H doesn't interfere in that match, I will be shocked.
Totally string things along, right?
Well, because I think we're good. Because we have the team match at Survivor Series.
Right.
I don't see Rollins, Jericho, and Owens being on that team.
Right.
So if you do Rollins versus Triple H at Survivor Series, boom, there's your other headliner.
That could be, yeah. I can see them doing it. You don't think they're going to push Triple H and Seth all the way to, like, maybe the big Royal Rumble or WrestleMania?
Nope.
No. Too far out, right?
Too long.
Triple H versus The Rock.
Really? You think so?
Sure. Sure. Why not?
Really, they should, right? Really, they should.
They've been teasing it for the longest time.
Have they?
Yeah.
Huh. All right.
You remember that whole thing of Ronda Rousey?
Oh,
I remember how Rock was supposed to have a match, but then the people who did Baywatch wouldn't let him.
That's right. That Baywatch movie that hasn't been out yet.
Yep.
Huh.
Yeah. Hollywood. You know when it's coming out, Sorg?
Huh.
Around WrestleMania time.
Oh boy. Oh boy. Is it, I hope it's I.
Not David gonna... Hasselhoff inducted to the WWE Hall of Fame.
Oh yeah.
Book it.
Make it happen. Make it happen.
As long as he drives Kit down the ramp.
Cruiserweight champion TJ Perkins, Brian Kendrick. Yay!
There should be a stipulation on this.
You think?
Mm.
Yeah. Like title versus career.
For the second Cruiserweight championship match ever?
No, for Brian Kendrick's story. It should be title versus career.
Mm.
It worked for SmackDown. No, I think it should, because give some actual stakes.
Yeah.
Give some actual stakes, because Brian Kendrick is acting like this is the last chance he'll ever get when this is already his second shot at the Cruiserweight title.
Yeah, it's really like the third last chance he's had so far.
Like,
so,
make it mean something.
Yeah, we need that too needs to change at this point.
Like, Brian Kendrick should have said, listen, you give me one more shot at this belt, I will put my career on the line because this is literally all I have left.
Yeah. I mean, that desperation definitely needs to be there.
And then you have him cheat to win. It keeps him the heel.
Mm-hmm. New Day, Cesaro, and Sheamus. I mentioned...
No, that was on Raw, Sorg. That was on Raw.
Yeah, I know, and I liked it on Raw. So let's see it again. Cesaro is an it factor. Cesaro's a tag team factor. I talked about on the wrap up, you know, he teamed with Tyson Kidd and had fire until Kidd got hurt. He teamed Kings of Wrestling with Chris Hero and it was amazing, right? He teamed with whoever that guy was of BDK and the guy that we thought looked like my brother at King of Trios. And it
Tursus?
Was Tursus, yes. And it was amazing. Who was the other one? Aries or something, maybe?
Probably.
It was amazing. Like, he is the common denominator in kick-ass tag teams. And now that we're past the we don't like each other and we're Facebook living every week, the two of them getting together and actually could be a forceful, badass tag team, I'm excited for.
Mm-hmm.
Cesaro needs to stop being in tag teams.
Well, at least he's good at it.
I don't want him to be more athletic Billy Gunn. I really don't.
By the way, Billy Gunn on Art of Wrestling this week, it's worth a listen. I'm about halfway through it. No, I think it'll be good. You know, New Day's had it for a while. I think it is time for, you know, maybe a little bit of that mixing around again.
No, Sorg, they've gone this far. They're holding the belts until they beat Demolition.
That's what I'm thinking.
That's what I honestly think.
Demolition has to make an appearance at some point.
You know what? You know what'll be great? Are they both alive?
Yes.
The last day of that title run, New Day needs to challenge Demolition.
Yeah. Well, Axe and Smash are. Axe and Smash
yeah.
definitely are.
Yeah,
I
Axe
want
and Smash.
To point out.
You
so.
Can do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can do it. Like, that would be... If it's New Day versus Demolition at Survivor Series, sign me up.
Even
I am all in.
Even if,
or even
like,
if it's like the Ascension dressed as Axe and Smash.
Even
I can see that. Yeah.
I'll accept that too.
Even
here
if
here comes
it's,
the Victor, here comes the Connor.
Unannounced, right? And they come out and Axe and Smash do. Like, even if it's a kind of a blow off match for that. Like, just that has to happen.
I mean, shit. The Shield wrestled the Outlaws at one point at WrestleMania. We
yeah,
could do New Day versus.
But
we could do New Day versus Demolition.
Have you seen Demolition lately?
Have you seen
yeah.
the Outlaws?
The Outlaws, I thought, hold up pretty good for their age.
Yeah.
So that's in a, did Demolition and Legion of Doom ever happen?
Yeah, like all the time.
It did.
Yeah, they had a match, I think.
Like, I don't know. I see them labeled for like WrestleMania. Seven? No, that didn't happen.
Huh. Yeah, like all the time, though.
Like all the time. They're like,
like
yeah,
all the time.
Yeah, remember?
Like, as soon as LOD came to WWE, they were like, okay, we're going to take out those clones.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, I'm looking at this picture of them over here, and I'm like, wow, they really just did like look at LOD and be like, you know what? We just need more spikes.
Yep.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. Ours will be tinier, though.
And silver.
And silver, yeah.
Lots
yeah.
of silver.
Silver paint that's probably poisonous. And a little more leather fetish thing going on here. You can tell
mm-hmm.
you can tell that's the thing that you know, Vince had to hand in because he's a,
well, obviously.
Because this
get some more leather in there, damn it.
Especially later when they got into like the leather mask thing. Like, that was definitely,
mm-hmm.
like, that's from Vince's personal collection, probably. You know? And then they got into threesomes, you know? Yeah.
Hashtag not my smasher.
Not my Darso. Hashtag not my Darso.
Repo Man for life.
Oh, the Royal Rumble promo where he says he's going to steal the title. I watched that recently.
He almost did.
He almost did. Yes, absolutely.
Bobby Heenan said he had a plan.
Had
Bobby Heenan was wrong.
Bobby Heenan freaking out that entire match is so amazing.
This is the best Hell in a Cell preview ever.
All right. Hey, let's talk about more Hell in a Cell in a moment. But first, let's mention IndieWrestling.us because that's where we're at right now. Yeah, we got a bunch of releases over there, including, of course, the Bloody Harvest behind me is out there on DVD and digital download. We're actually reformatting some stuff, trying to make it a little easier for you guys to get in there and check out all the titles. The Lost RWA show, Spring Fling, is out. Sorry, guys. Sorry. We fixed that one. It's out there. And also, brand new PCW, Premier Championship Wrestling, which, okay, I need to call out our friends at PCW. They're happening in Cleveland.
PCW.
A lot of friends are involved with it. Battle of the Beards, Matt Cross and Jason Kincaid. Guys like Facade, Chris LaRusso, Gory. But their latest couple of shows, not on our site yet, they just had a Revengeance. Old IWC fans will remember Revengeance. And I just saw their next one is named
yep.
November Pain. So I'm just saying, kind of interesting. A lot of faces connected in there. Little, it's going to get very confusing because there's definitely a few shows named those if when they finally go in our digital downloads.
Sorg, have you ever tried to name a big wrestling show?
I have
named. Pretty much everything is taken.
I have named wrestling shows. I have contributed
I know,
to a couple
recently.
Of them. Last year.
Okay.
Last year.
A lot of things are taken.
The dance was mine.
Okay. All right.
I mean, come on, Mike. You think about it. I mean, everybody that has a show in December, what do they call it?
St. Valentine's Day Massacre, because they're confused.
What? Jesus Christ, Mike.
What are they doing in Poughkeepsie, man?
Right.
Is that how wrestling rolls up there?
We have weird winters.
And we're not talking about the wrestler.
Exactly.
Hey-o. Anyways, indiewrestling.us.
God, remember winter? Jeez, I'm sorry, Sorg. I just got horrible TNA flashbacks.
Sorry.
It's like being a nun.
No, I remember her when she was in when she was in WWE. And they had that weird, like kind of almost, you know, incestuous thing going on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that too.
Yeah.
And then she had a lesbian love angle with Angelina Love.
Really?
Hashtag not my cobblepot.
Oh.
God, I knew it was going to come around.
Oh.
No. Oh, man. Sorg, you know what we need to do one day?
Finish
when
the
TNA
sad?
Finally dies.
Finish the sad?
We need. Well, yeah. Finish the ad first.
Yeah.
Teaser. Around the indies. Riz writes it. Stuff happens in the indies. Also, our interviews for Indie Mayhem show. We just talked to the Rev Ron Hunt. That's going to be up on the Indie Mayhem show later this week. So go check it out. IndieWrestling.us. Sign up for the newsletter. Get all the info on new releases and Wrestling Mayhem show. Fun stuffs. Mike, tell me about TNA.
Sork, when TNA dies, we need to have a remember when about TNA. But just have it be like a 3-hour show.
I hope it dies by Christmas so we can do that as our special edition.
Oh, Sorg! Oh my God, I just got the best idea. I'm going to do a TNA Christmas Carol. The ghost of TNA past, the ghost of TNA present, and the ghost of TNA future. with Dixie Bod Crane. Ebenezer Corgan.
Oh
yes, this is gonna be a thing.
Yep.
Oh man.
All right.
Oh, what day? You there, boy? What day is this? Why, it's Slammiversary Day.
And when you do TNA present, just show NXT and SmackDown.
No, that's the ghost of TNA future. The ghost of TNA future is TakeOver WrestleMania 33. That's what it is. Because Austin Aries, Eric Young, Bobby Roode, Samoa Joe, they're all there.
Yep.
Coming soon, Broken Matt Hardy.
Hey, and we know where James Storm is now.
No, we don't.
No? Nope, wait, what happened to James Storm?
Oh, it's not good.
Sorry, Mike. Sorry to bring that up, but God.
Sorry about your damn.
By the way, I'm so happy Eric Young popped up as Sanity.
Yeah, he's really great.
What it was, Mike? Were you the one saying that it's a breath of fresh air in Nikki Cross in the women's division?
Yes.
Like, I'm so happy with that. I think that needs to be kind of discussed. Is you know, everybody was kind of worried about, oh no, where's the women's division? Oh, all the good people went on. But NXT NXT finds a way, right?
Like I was looking at it, like, really hard, and I'm like, I think we're gonna be okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like people aren't where they should be yet.
Mm-hmm.
But they're getting there.
The way the system works, it creates these opportunities for these guys and girls. And there will always be somebody to step up into the holes. Much like every time somebody disappeared, like a Steve Austin in the Attitude Era, somebody stepped up in and we got our Triple H's and our Rocks, right? And yeah, they have to fill it in the gaps a little bit now. We're getting Mickey James against Asuka coming up.
Do you know who that was supposed to be, though, right?
Who was it supposed to be?
It was supposed to be Trish.
Really?
But because they're in Toronto, Trish's hometown. However, she just announced she's pregnant with her second kid.
She's just a baby factory. Trish.
Mm-hmm. Hashtag not my Stratus. No, seriously, though. Congratulations, Trish.
We know you watch. We know you're watching, Trish.
Yeah, we know. We know.
Uh-huh.
We know you're out there. But
your husband is so seriously stratified.
I wow. Yep.
That too far, Wheels. Too far. Too far. No, but but Mickie James is on there. That's kind of cool. I wish they did like a video or something about it. I'm sure that's probably coming. Mm-hmm. But I mean, and there's another TNA exile. It's gonna be a takeover.
Of sorts, yeah. It's been more like kind of GFW and stuff and indies.
Sorg
also had
TNA killed her with a train.
I really hope somewhere in the match is Corey Graves talking about how Mickie James has been around the world, yada yada yada, as in everywhere except TNA, and it just somewhere in there, and she has recovered from injuries. And especially that incident with the train, and just like doesn't refer anymore and just moves on.
I hope he just says like Asuka hit her like a freight train. That's all I need. That's all I need right there. That's all I need for it.
So good.
That's really all I need.
Oh, so happy with that. So very happy with that.
But yeah, and even with the Dusty Tag Team Classic. There are some fun tag teams in there.
Mm-hmm.
I forget their names now. The guys who wrestled Aries and Strong. I want to see them as a real team.
Oh, Tucker Knight and the other guy?
Yeah, Tucker Knight and the other guy.
Because I am 100% in Team Tucker Knight.
Yeah. It was like Team Fat Guy Spike. It was great.
Yeah. You're also looking at it, you're like, how... like. These are big guys. Austin Aries is not a big guy.
No, not by any stretch of the imagination.
And it was just like, and he was cutting down these trees of men. You know, it was pretty. I mean, pretty great showing to show them off. You know, so I thought that was pretty cool. That was good.
Yeah, and Roddy Strong is in NXT. I mean, you know, that's a thing that happened.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, NXT is going to be okay. Everyone, TNA. Not so much.
Not so good.
Yeah, not so much. Although, Sorg, did you hear about the guy that's going to be debuting in TNA?
No.
I think it's this week. I think he might even be a friend of the show.
Wait, what?
I'm not entirely positive. There's a three-man group that's coming into TNA. I won't spoil who they are for those people who do care about TNA spoilers. Two of them are TNA guys through and through.
Mm-hmm.
The third guy, well, I'll just say this. I'm sure Alex Karras knows him quite well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's all I'll say, too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm trying to work my head around it.
And he might be related to someone in the New Day.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, what? Yep,
that's all I'm guessing. I'm kidding, but...
What?
Well, think about the New Day.
New Day.
Which ones of them have last names?
Yeah.
Kingston, and Woods.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Kingston. Think of Kingston.
Kingston.
Wrestlers. Names Kingston.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, I heard about him.
We basically spoiled it, but I'm okay with that.
No one who
watches us watch TNA anyway. They watch the midweek war to hear me bitch about TNA. No, it's Eddie Kingston. Eddie Kingston's gonna be in TNA.
Yeah, we don't have to tell them who the other two are.
No, because fuck those guys.
Yeah, because sorry about their damn luck.
Ah. Oh my. Oh my. Well, hey, good for him for getting on TV though, somewhere off of basic cable.
Well, he's still kind of on basic cable.
I'm just gonna fade away and classify myself as obsolete.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
Delete.
This is way better than whatever I had lined up for this segment, anyways. Talk about NXT TNA, guys.
Yeah. But yeah, just TNA, man. Like that last week's episode. I don't know if you guys watched me do the midweek war. I had to do it solo because Aiden was having issues. It was a rough watch. I almost didn't do it. I almost just did NXT Lucha and just had a test pattern for 10 minutes for TNA.
After watching the things that I did, I could see why, Mike.
Yeah. No, I mean, it's like when you're watching a movie, but it's a documentary, and you know the historical event, and you know how... It's like watching the movie Titanic. like you see, oh, what a great ship. They're all going to die.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that, like, because even... I'm not comparing it to the Titanic, because even when the Titanic
ship.
Well, it is. But even when the Titanic sank, the band still played. TNA can't even get music rights at this point. Their Smashing Pumpkins frontman is leaving them and suing them.
On that note,
despite all his rage, he's still a rat. Leaving that cage.
Hey, I enjoyed the Cody Rhodes Eddie match though. I enjoyed that one.
Yeah, that was great for no reason. That was great. His second match in, he gets a world title shot without any build up.
But it was still a good match.
Yeah, with a roll up ending.
Guys, I want to tell you about our friends that have been supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with pepperoni pizza for a good long time, and they got a new website, sliceonbroadway.com, our good friends here in the Pittsburgh area on the Broadway, Carnegie, PA, and PNC Park, home of the Pittsburgh Pirates, who are not in season right now. That's okay. But our good friends of the show doing some great pizza artistry. And supporting the show and the guests that pop in here.
We need to get some Slice on Broadway and PPG Paints Arena.
Mm-hmm.
So it can be the perfect pepperoni pizza for PPG Paints Arena for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
You get to do that one.
I did that on purpose.
You get to do that one. They still have to change all the signs. Everything still says Console Arena around there. So.
Well, they haven't painted it over yet, Sorg.
Oh, yes. Localized jokes. But anyways, check them out. SliceOnBroadway.com, PGH_Slice on the Twitter, and Slice on Broadway on the Facebook and the Instagram. Let them know Wrestling Mayhem Show sent you. The latest tweet from Discover the Berg. Have you been to Slice in Beachview yet? It is probably the best New York style pizza in Pittsburgh. Mike?
I concur.
There's a thumbs up.
As a certified New Yorker.
There you go. What's in his driver's license?
Did I like pizza?
Yes, he's a pizza donor. Okay. We'll be right back with the big question. Let's talk tech. Tech news discussions from the people in the industry right here in Pittsburgh. Online, gadgets, startups, and more. Check it out at awesomecast.net. Wrestling Mayhem Show with us. It's, of course, Mad Mike. Doing this like weird wavy like bird thing with his hands.
I'm letting the pigeons loose.
Like it's almost, like it looks like, but it looks like you're adding a little bit of seductiveness to it. It's really, really weird.
You're welcome. You're welcome,
ladies. And also Wheels, representing California, PA, and Poughkeepsie, New York, respectively. Pittsburgh, PA. Me and my couch here in Pittsburgh, PA. But hey. Somebody told me earlier, I don't know how I feel, I don't think it's a compliment, said that our couch setup over there looks like RF video. Do you see it?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, I can see it.
All right. Even more so when we get drunk for the Christmas episode. It's time for the big question. Of course, some big news. Apparently, I'm swapping this up. AJ Styles shared an image stylized for the Royal Rumble, which is going to be happening at the Alamo Dome in San Antonio, Texas, of course, as you probably heard if you watch wrestling, AJ Styles and Shawn Michaels.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think he didn't say anything with it, right?
Yeah. No, I think he just said, like, interesting image or something like that.
Mm.
He pulled a Finn Balor.
Mm. So, whether that happens or not, it still is like, oh, hey, yeah, that's something I'd like to see. Oh, hey, that's kind of a dream match. As we're getting, you know, we're getting to the point where we're pulling in Goldberg as the, hey, let's have a dream match here against Brock Lesnar, the dream match nobody wanted to see rematched, or practically the first time, actually. You know, it feels like we're running out of these dream match opportunities.
Yeah, Sork, he said, interesting photo, is it not?
Yeah. So we're down to, the question is, what dream matches are left? Or are there new dream matches? And that's not a direct answer to that. What dream matches do you think are still out there that you'd like to see?
Ooh, I got a good one. It hit me as soon as it thought about it.
I told you.
I want to say one, but I feel like it's the one I always say, so I'm not going to
Wheels,
say
it. Let's say you.
All right. I say me, and it deals with Styles. Are you laughing at my face?
That was a weird response. Like, I was okay, go ahead.
I'm sorry. I'm going to go with this one. AJ versus Triple H.
Ooh. Ooh, that could be good. That could
That's
be good.
That's not bad.
That could be good. Because, I mean, either way, it's like just Triple H is so good.
I mean,
good.
They both can still go. And I mean, Trip still looks great. Him and AJ could just throw down all over it. Even if they made it a false count anywhere, they could just go balls out.
I could see, like, this is something that could roll into maybe next year after whatever, you know, plays out, where you have the face that runs a place and the King of Kings takes exception to that, right?
Mm-hmm.
I could definitely see that kind of happening, you know, or maybe whatever plays out with Triple H, Kevin Owens, Seth Rollins, and then, you know, that maybe ostracizes Triple H from Raw. So now he's kind of floating around SmackDown a little bit, right? And
causing... goes after the champ that runs the camp.
Yeah, yeah, like that could happen, and that could be a really interesting match. I like it.
Thank you,
Mike.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say Taker Sting, but obviously that's not gonna happen ever again. Mm-hmm. So I'm trying to think of guys that can go and can do stuff, and I don't know if it's really a dream match for anyone, but I feel like given what I'm looking at for like active guys in WWE, the most interesting dream match I can think of, The Rock versus Shinsuke Nakamura.
Wow.
Mm.
I don't know what that match is, but I know I will be entertained as fuck.
Yeah. I mean,
totally two different styles, and it's, oh, wow.
A lot more needs to happen with Shinsuke to get to that point, right?
I mean,
do that match in Japan, sure. But doing that here, it's still like Shinsuke is popular amongst a certain section, not necessarily like Shinsuke isn't Raw popular. Shinsuke is
not yet.
Not yet. Sword, no. Obviously,
it took Finn Balor one entrance on Raw for him to be off. I'm pretty sure Shinsuke would be the same way.
That's true.
Like Finn Balor, it took one entrance.
Right.
It took him one night to be like, "Oh my God, Finn Balor, where have you been?" Mm. Like, I feel like Nakamura could do the same thing. I feel like if you have like The Rock come out and announce he's coming to WWE, and you just have Nakamura interrupt him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, bingo. That's it.
So the most electrifying man against the he's Shinsuke.
Yeah, man. Against Nakamura.
Yeah,
it's I don't know what that is. I don't know what those promos are. I just feel like I need to have it in my life.
I feel like, and I think we're in an interesting, this is kind of off topic a little bit, but I think we're in an interesting spot where matches that we have seen on the NXT level can certainly be recycled down the line for wrestling, WrestleMania. I am an advocate for Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn, title or not, I don't even care, happening with some weight to it at WrestleMania this year. And maybe you could say maybe give it another year or something like that. But it needs to, this feud that has gone forever, the Fight Forever feud, culminates at WrestleMania.
But one of them would have to leave the show. One of them would have to go to SmackDown for it to be the culmination. Otherwise, they're going to keep running.
It depends on what they do with it. And that's a problem to be solved for later. But the point of my discussion now is then you also have somewhere down the line, after both of them have gotten their time to shine and everybody's like, oh yeah, these guys are awesome, we get Shinsuke and Finn Balor. Say at WrestleMania, say at SummerSlam, wherever the case may be. Have a classic match between these guys. Have insane intros by both of these guys, right? Not just, like, you didn't get the Demon versus Nakamura, right? You got Finn, like a friendly. Yeah, you got Finn and Nakamura in a TV match.
You got Finn the Lego Master versus Nakamura.
Yeah. SummerSlam 95 watching Finn Balor. against Shinsuke. So there's room for that turning into something eventually, right?
Also, and this is me personally. American Alpha versus Team Angle.
Oh, yes.
I don't know where Charlie Haas is.
That's a good one.
I just want
somebody this. Dust up, somebody dig up Charlie Haas, make this happen. And of course, there's plenty of the ones like I feel like something like Rhino, Sammy Callahan, we saw a couple weeks ago in House of Hardcore, was a pretty like wow, that's the match I didn't know I needed in my life. So it really was. And I think there's a lot left on the table that I wish we could call out. Edge versus like anybody, Daniel Bryan versus almost anybody active on the roster right now.
Bryan versus literally anyone. Oh, jeez!
I mean, just think about it. Yeah. Bryan versus Seth. Bryan versus Dean. Bryan versus
hell,
Owens. Sammy.
Bring in Christopher Daniels. Do a rematch of TNA's greatest match of all time.
AJ.
Imagine this AJ, this Joe, and this Daniels.
Oh,
jeez. That's something.
That is hell in a cell.
Well, then that's something to think about, too. Let's bring up, or even dream rematch. I would love to see. I want to see Angle and Joe in WWE.
I don't know if I want to see Kurt Angle.
I personally am such a fan of what those two guys both did in TNA.
Mm-hmm.
Like what it is. Probably definitely my favorite TNA feud. Okay. And I would just love to see them go at it one more time. This could be Angle's swan song match, right? Because I feel like Brock could have been it, but I wouldn't want to see Brock and Angle now.
Oh God, no.
No.
Angle would literally die.
Right.
Would literally be killed in the ring.
It would, you know, I would like to see, I would like to see this, like, Joe now versus Angle. Again, kind of that swan song thing. Maybe it transitions Angle into, you know, whatever his phase is going to be. Maybe, man, Angle would make a great agent, wouldn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
as long as he stays clean, yeah.
Well, yeah, I think WWE would help him with that in that case. But, like, just Angle being around as a commissioner, as anything, I think would be just beneficial to everybody. So,
are there any dream women's matches that you guys can think of? Because, like, I would like to see
Lita's retired, but not for anything physical, right?
No, I would like to see like Lita and Trish versus the BFF, Sasha and Charlotte.
Yeah, I agree. I was just thinking that one. Yep.
Like Mickey and Asuka was, like, again, the dream match I didn't know I wanted. I would take Alita, Trish, or Mickey against any of the four horsewomen.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind seeing Victoria versus Nia Jax.
Ooh.
Yeah, and Victoria can still go. She looked good at Chikara. Jazz looked good in Chikara. Seeing them go, man, I was surprised to see the WWE women, Mickey, Jazz, and Victoria in mixed tag action, like in intergender accent action. It was pretty tremendous. So there was that. No, definitely. Any one of
those awesome Kong versus Nia.
Oh, I completely forgot about Awesome Kong.
That is the match that would bring DJ Lunchbox back to wrestling.
Or Awesome Kong versus Trish Stratus.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah.
Yeah. That would be shit. That would be. All right. That's my dream women's match. Awesome Kong and Trish Stratus. Yeah.
This is a match that I think I would have loved to see about 2 or 3 years ago. AJ Lee against Lita.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
could have been fantastic. Or
this is also a match I would like to see 3 years ago. The Beautiful People versus the Bella Twins.
Ooh.
I think the match would not have been spectacular, but the story in it would be amazing, I think.
Has Hardy's Young Bucks happened?
Yeah.
Okay.
It happened in Poughkeepsie, and I couldn't go. Because I was working.
Like, did it happen for real or like
NEW?
Okay. So in that case, okay.
Yep.
I'm sure that was a blast.
Yeah, the broken ones have not faced the Bucks of Youth on television.
Mm.
Or the Day of the New. You don't watch TNA, Sork. That was said on Impact.
Yeah.
The Day of the New.
All right.
It doesn't even make any sense.
We mentioned it before, New Day Demolition.
Or, you know, how about the New Day versus Big E Langston, Kofi Kingston, and Consequences Creed? Like, them versus their former selves.
How about Xavier Woods and Kofi Kingston against Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston?
All right, that's it. Fine. I'm going to go for there. I'm going to go New Day versus The Nation.
Yeah.
That's – well, wait. Which three members of The Nation would you pick?
Okay. I'm going to go –
would you do original, like Farouk, Crush, yes. Savio?
I would go Farouk, Savio, yeah. Savio, yeah. And Rock.
Okay. Oh, man.
Could you picture the promos back and forth?
Well, The Rock's already interacted with New Day a little bit, hasn't he?
Yeah, didn't they beat them all up that one WrestleMania?
That's what I thought, yeah.
You think, but it still would be classic Rock versus New Day as The Nation, though.
But New Day wasn't at full steam yet when that happened.
Yeah.
Like, New Day was like, do we really have to shit on New Day right now? They have enough problems. at the time, they were still in that awkward heel positivity thing that everybody was booing. So,
Enzo and Cass and Too Cool.
I think Enzo and Cass were too new to have a dream match for them. I think they're too new to have like a dream match associated with them.
Yeah. Okay. Good point.
That's like saying I have a dream match for Ember Moon.
Good point. Very good point.
Ember Moon and Jazz.
Ooh. Okay. I mean, it'd be a great match. That would be a really fun match.
Ember Moon and Victoria. I'm making it work. I'm making it work. I keep forgetting she's on the roster because I haven't seen her in a month on that show. Because there's so many people.
NXT is weird.
It is really like, oh wait, this is a person that happens.
You know what match? I think it could happen. I think it would be really interesting, even though I don't especially like one of the people on here. Austin Aries and Randy Orton.
Ooh.
Yeah, it could be good. Dude, Austin Aries when he gets the main roster is going to be devastating. You watch.
Oh, he's going to fall so hard.
You, really?
He's going to get Tyler Breezed.
No. He's too good.
Yes, he will, Sorg.
He's too good. He's not like a gimmicky thing like Tyler Breeze is. He's a dude that can talk on the mic and do amazing things. He might get in, like, IC title land with Dolph and Miz, but man, Miz now and Aries now?
That would be fun.
That would be great.
Oh, actually, did we ever get Miz versus Rock?
No.
Did we ever get that? Like, one-on-one?
No, never.
That's a legit one that has never happened, I didn't think.
I guess, yeah.
I know they've done tags and stuff, but
That's right.
Miz versus Rock would be real interesting.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to make you guys giggle a little bit on this one. Are you ready?
Yes.
Bobby Roode versus the Axeman, Curtis Axel.
No. No.
Wait. No. Explain.
No.
No, explain?
No.
No.
You're just leaving that there?
Wheels, that doesn't work.
Sure. Oh. It'd be who would be the most perfect man, or who would be so rude? You'd have the old rude and perfect.
No, I see what you're doing there.
No, no.
But, come on.
No, first of all, rude isn't spelled right.
I don't care. It's glorious.
Guys, I think it's time to finally do this. What did you learn? What did you learn from wrestling this week?
Ooh. You know what I learned? It was something you guys were talking about earlier, and I have to agree. I learned that a piece of paper is super over, and I was very entertained, even when Braun Strowman had the list.
Yeah, it was.
I enjoyed it very much, and I've also learned that Braun Strowman likes to have things asked politely of him. Mm-hmm. When he told Jericho, say please.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's just manners. Yeah. That's just manners.
But when a big, gigantic man tells you to say that, you listen.
That's true. I learned that there is no amount of energy that can take the strength out of Enzo's hand microphone.
Holy crap, yes.
So good. I didn't get to talk about it on the wrap-up last night. That was one of the most amazing things I've seen on Raw in a great long time. And I felt a little bad because the crowd kind of forgot what the first part of Big Cass's part was. They kind of forgot, but they're all with him by the time he pointed.
Then that's fine. That's fine by me. Wow. From the
face, I just assume it's because Big Cass doesn't have a mic tattooed on his hand like Enzo does.
Yeah. From Facebook, Bobby FJ Town learned not to be sour.
As he
has a picture of his New Day Funko Pops 3-pack, along with a 2K17 picture of Nakamura. I think he got like the crazy NXT pack over there.
Fuck, how did he get that already?
I don't know.
I work at a Toys R Us and I haven't been able to get
it. Matthew T out there says, did you know that Sasha was an Eddie fan?
that was a little much.
Yeah, yeah. So just in case you hadn't heard. What did I learn? What did I learn?
Did you learn that Chavo Classic is still alive? Because I also learned that.
Was that a Lucha Underground thing?
Lucha Underground.
I was not aware of that. Like, I saw the tweet. I'm like, did they really just dig up Chavo Classic on there?
Yeah, they did. Holy crap. Yeah, they did, Sork.
Oh, jeez. I still need to drop another $40 and watch season two.
Yeah, you do.
Damn it. Damn it. That will, I don't know, happen someday. Shit, what did I learn?
What did you learn, Sorg? Did you learn about strip clubs in New York City?
No, but, you know, I learned that sometimes when a wrestler calls himself a reverend, he may actually be an ordained minister. That was from our interview with the Rev earlier today. That's going to be on this week's Indie Mayhem show.
Have you booked him for a wedding? Because you should.
Georgie's looking for a match.
This is what I'm saying.
Oh, dude, he would be so great. Mm-hmm. That's it. The Rev. Hold on. I'm going to text Chachi. Hold on.
The greatest thing ever.
Anytime at Mad Day, so it's going to be great. Do you still need a minister for the wedding?
Sorg, if he balks on the Rev, you could always try and call the Doctor of Desire Slick.
That's right.
Or Million Dollar Man.
I was gonna say, or Ted DiBiase
officiating the wedding.
Or actually, there's another wrestling reverend we know. That's
been, Church.
There's Church.
Yeah.
Okay, he's sleeping because he's had.
I don't think Devon's a real reverend though.
No, he's the only one that I'm not clear on.
But Batista is a deacon. That's.
Oh, my brother, testify.
I'm sorry. I saw a tweet.
Not my baby.
Somebody asked Batista if he was voting for a certain individual in the election. And, like,
so good.
Man, so good. Safe filter was off for Batista.
He reacted like we do. He reacted like we do when we're drunk during a Christmas show and asked if we like TNA. Like, fuck no!
Yeah, it was
all
great.
Caps Drax! Hashtag all caps Drax.
Yes.
Also, related to that, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 trailer, go watch it. It's got me excited. There's a Drax hug. Spoiler alert.
So another side note of trailers. I can't wait to see The Breakfast Club meets Power Rangers.
Me too. And it has nothing to do with wrestling wheels.
Listen,
it's
okay.
It can only go a few degrees out from wrestling on this show. And we almost went a little further than that with the strip clubs earlier. Guys.
I brought it back.
Guys, I still just feel like we should apologize to our guest that was not on the show based on tonight's conversation. MadMike4883 on the Twitter in Poughkeepsie, New York. The only one of us with a future endeavored letter from the WWE. And, of course, at Hot Wheels RWA, RWA Live. I'm sorry. No. Yeah. RWALive.com, RWA Pro on Twitter. They got a show coming up November 12th. We will be there. I swear we're actually going to do this time. We had to cancel the last one because family issues mostly. But we are going to be doing a Mayhem show live at the Renegade Wrestling Alliance show, which is open season.
I will be there.
You will be there at open season, and we're going to see who we can get on. I'm sure we'll have Church on. We'll have maybe we can grab Sanjay Dutt while we're at, because I know he's booked on the show as well. That should be a lot of fun. And I think we might be doing another one the next day, because I think Code Red's doing a show the next day. I haven't confirmed it yet, but that might be a possibility too. Stay tuned for information on that. Also, if you're in the Pittsburgh area, we're doing a studio wrestling mixer. Look on Sorgatron Media's Facebook page. I think we might tag the Wrestling Mayhem show as well. A little bit of getting to know people that are in the community for old school Pittsburgh wrestling. Had a great time last Wednesday, actually sitting down. Bucky Palermo was the shoemaker to the stars, as in he did shoes for and cleats for the World Series original Dynasty Pittsburgh Steelers, Yammer Yager, Mario Lemieux, and also was a boxing referee, a Buster Douglas. He's done a fight or two of his, I understand. Also, referee to Studio Wrestling, Bruno Sammartino, George the Animal Steel, a bear at one point, by the way, because there was apparently a line of George the Animal Steel versus a bear. And he was the referee for much of that tour, including, you know, Andre the Giant, Hulk Hogan, when they were in town for stuff too. So really cool discussion there. Really cool too. Oh, side note, you know our intro music, Basic Sickness. The other guy, his hype man in the band, He is Bucky's grandson.
Wow.
Hmm.
Yeah. No idea. He's like there, and I'm like, this guy looks familiar. This guy looks familiar. I haven't seen this guy in like years, right? Probably like 5+ years. And we've done shows together, right? And I'm like, and I hand him my card. He's like, oh, I remember you. And he's like, Basic Sickness? I'm like, yeah, it's our theme music. He's like, I'm the other guy in the band. I'm like, yes. So like, yes, other guy. So that was fun. That was fun. Also, shout out to Dave Fedor, referee at KSWA. Also got some old school connections with him and pre-Wrestling Mayhem show world. So good to catch up with him last week as well. I don't know. I'm just throwing shout outs here at the end of the show. This is where I can do it, right? Thanks again, mm-hmm. Alex Kars. Check out the Occupy Pro Wrestling podcast, the OPW podcast, and figure out what the hell I said because I still need to. RWALive.com, we mentioned that. Mad Mike doing the Midweek War. Go watch it and like it and give him props because he's watching TNA, so you don't have to.
I really am. This is a sacrifice that I do for the good of the Mayhem universe.
Indeed.
You said sacrifice.
Trust me. Fuck. I did.
Delete.
Hey, you know what? There has never been a more aptly named TNA
pay-per-view. Oh, no. Oh, no. Thank you so much, guys. We'll see you guys next time. Mayhem Show out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.